Is this the bean or what?
It's a bean.
It's a bean.
You got bean for everything.
It looks like a burrito bowl.
I thought the same, but I didn't say that.
So this one is called Baião de Dois.
Baião de Dois.
Baião de Dois.
Fala galera, beleza com vocês? A gente tá aqui de novo pra fazer mais vídeo com gringo. E a gente tá aqui em Cork hoje, que o Bruno preparou pra gente uma comida especial pra dar pros gringos provarem. O que você preparou pra eles?
Baião de Dois.
O que eles acharam das comidas brasileiras que o Bruno preparou pra eles aí?
Espero que eles gostem, né?
Baião de Dois.
Baião.
Paião?
De dois.
De dois.
Yeah. Paião de dois.
No idea why.
Paião de dois.
What does it mean?
No idea.
Seriously.
I think paião is maybe a dance, and then de dois is for two.
Oh yeah?
A dance for two.
No relation whatsoever.
Paião de dois.
Paião de dois.
Baião de dois.
Baião de dois, no? Baião de dois.
You love your beans in Brazil, don't you? Jesus.
This is good.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's better than...
Fish
water. It's a bit dry though.
No, I like this.
Yeah?
Yeah. No, it's not that heavy.
Yeah, rice. Rice, beans again, and some form of white meat, such pork or chicken.
Are you filming now?
Yeah.
Mmm. It's very hot.
And what do you think is in it?
Chorizo?
Oh, yeah, that's really good.
How does that? How is that? Not as Turkish as it.
And would this be starter or main course?
Main, yeah.
Yeah, it's very nice. The pork is really tender with the rice, and I really like it.
Too much pork?
No, like, not about the pork, like, don't know. About the rice, maybe. It's a bit heavy for me.
I think it needs a bit sauce, maybe, or something. It's
dry?
Yeah, maybe a bit dry, yeah.
What's it called? Pequeño? Pequeño, yeah. I don't really dislike anything about it.
I don't think there's an awful lot of flavor in it, though, do you?
I think so. I can taste the chorizo, bacon. There's some sort of sauce on it.
Oh, we lost that one. We're going to have to try again. Thanks, man. We got two this time. Excellent.
It's your punch. No, it's better because, as I told, like, it's kind of like dry.
Yeah,
that's like you can feel like a blend of
juice.
Yeah,
so it definitely gives a nice bit of extra flavor.
Is it the spicy pepper?
It's very light.
Yeah. Ah, okay.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Is it very spicy?
No, not so much.
I haven't tried that kind of pepper.
It's called piquinho.
Piquinho.
I like it with that, yeah.
For sure, it's really tasty, I thought, like, you know.
Yeah.
To be honest, but I prefer, I don't know, I like the rice in this, that's it.
Yeah.
Fish rada with rice would be lovely, I'd say.
Yeah, you could even throw fish rada on this and
then
take it off.
Yeah. Good idea.
This is probably what we're more normal to eating, like. We usually eat this more.
Yeah, like the fish rada is kind of out of our comfort zone, yeah. Small, but I'd say.
It's probably more our comfort zone.
I'd put in a sauce, definitely.
Gravy.
Gravy, yeah, gravy's a real Irish sauce.
I would definitely add maybe tomato sauce. To make it more moisture, and I think maybe it would even taste a little bit better. Maybe with even some more spices.
I don't eat pork at all, so I could just try for the rice. So if I could get, you know, taste for chicken or let's say like beef or something inside, maybe I could change my mind.
I would like to put some cheese there. I love cheese, so.
I can prefer with tomato sauce as well, like tomato sauce or some black pepper or oregano with oregano.
Something like that. I put a few of those into it, yeah. To be honest. That's really nice.
Add a bit of flavor to it.
Like a cheesy kind of sauce, huh?
I'm seeing more tomato.
Tomato sauce?
Not like ketchup, but tomato sauce.
When would you eat something like that, do you feel like, if you were to have this,
after football?
Yeah.
Like lunch or dinner.
You could do lunch or dinner, yeah.
Yeah, I would eat it maybe for lunch or for dinner. I don't know if I would eat it maybe every day, because maybe it would be a little bit too heavy. Yeah, I would definitely eat it again. Yeah.
But no, it's more like kind of quick stuff you make at home, like.
Yeah.
Simple stuff.
It's like stuff from the end of the fridge, you know?
Yeah.
Like leftover food, you know?
What is the flavor like? Anything that reminds you of any local flavors?
No, nothing local. I think a lot of these ingredients could be locally sourced. You could probably get them everywhere. But I have had Chinese food that tastes similar to it before.
Well, we have lots of type of risottos in Italy, so we always put meat inside and different type of mushrooms or vegetables. It's really similar. Usually the risotto is more liquid, it's not so dry. It seems more like a paella or something similar.
Mm. Yeah, so in Mexico we have frijoles charros, beans and some kind of sausage stir. So it's kind of similar, just with rice.
Would you eat it again?
Definitely.
Sometimes.
Maybe not.
I'm so hungry.
I think for dinner I wouldn't eat it because I think it's kind of heavy and I want to have a good sleep. But yeah, I will eat it again, yeah.
So compared to the feijoada, which one do you prefer or what's the difference that you're feeling?
For him, exactly.
I like the feijoada.
I prefer this than the Beyond the Doors.
Yeah? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Why?
Because it's more moist, and for me the other type of rice reminds me more of paella that is really dry sometimes.
I prefer feijoada because we can put that one and it's nice.
Espero que vocês tenham curtido, não esquece de se inscrever no canal também, liga o sininho para você ser notificado de quando tiver coisa nova. Valeu, gente, até a próxima.
Tchau, obrigado.
I wouldn't eat it if I have more options, yeah, I would. But Brazilians, they would, like, they love this.
The first stuff we had is pure, like, it's out of your comfort zone.
Right, mm-hmm. And the Brazilians love this stuff.
Yeah, they love it.
Yeah, I should be dying, right?
No. Oh yeah, I should take that up.